Welcome back to the Roadside Rescue YouTube channel. I'm Ernest, and on this episode, I'm gonna be talking about EV chargers. I've got this Andeman WS1 EV charger here. I also brought the HS1 with me. I'll talk about that a little bit, but I'm gonna be reviewing this WS1. Not only that, I'm gonna be talking about why you might wanna buy your own personal charger rather than charging at a public charging station. I'll talk about the different pros and cons and the different levels of chargers you might wanna get. Well, let me go ahead and unbox this and we'll talk about what's in it. Now I'm pulling out the WS1 and it's much larger than this HS1. So let me go ahead and just show this to you real quick. This is a level 2 charger. It puts out 32 amps. So that's 29 miles an hour. And this is a portable charger, but you could also use this at your home as well. Because of that, I have a washing machine plug adapter here for EV chargers. And here's the charger itself. We'll talk about how this one's a little different and compare it to the kinds you can find outside. But that's the main thing you should notice now is how compact and portable this level 2 HS1 charger is. Instruction manual and mounting hardware. But here's where we can already notice the difference as we're unboxing this. This one's much larger. And that could be good or bad for you, and I'll talk about the differences. Well, when it comes to your own charger, let me tell you that you want to get one with a medium size or a long size cord. I recommend 20 to 25 feet as a minimum. That's what we have here is 24 feet, and that'll allow you to charge your car in whatever orientation you park it in. Now, unlike the HS1, this WS1 is meant to stay where it's put. In other words, that's the portable option. This kind you can wire straight into your home. This is the same style clip that Andeman uses for their HS1. I was mentioning when I mounted this one up, it's actually one of my favorite mounts. Because of the geometry, you can see it leaves the handle pointing downwards. It's at a very ergonomic spot to grab and pull out of the wall. Most handles that I've seen go straight into the wall, and it's just a little more uncomfortable to get unhooked. So that's definitely a plus for this Andeman. Now, of course, even though this is meant to be inside, it is still water resistant. Has a water protective cap here. And this is your typical F-series plug that also fit in the standard EV chargers. All right, well, I'm not gonna be able to unplug that one. This is the same style charging port you'll find in these public chargers. Well, the mounting options for this one are really secure. It also has a Bluetooth and Wi-Fi compatible app, so you can monitor your charging or set it up to charge, not during peak hours. And here's a quick look at that app. It's real easy to use. You can set it up to delay the charge so it's not charging during peak hours. The app's real easy to navigate, and you can even adjust how many amps you're charging with. So it's pretty customizable, not only the output you got, but you can also set it up for delay charging. And while I get this set up, I'll talk about the advantages of owning your own personal charger. Okay, so let's go ahead and mount up this WS1. I just got back to my truck here. Something that you need to know when you mount this up is this little tab here. It comes locked into place. You're just going to need to use a screwdriver or something to push that back. Just like that when you pull it down. All right, so here's how easy it is to install these mounts. I would recommend at least 2 screws. You could put all 4 in. And now that I've got that installed, it's locked in the wall. And that's what's nice about that tab. Once you lock it into place, it's really locked down. I mentioned I love the angle of this mounting handle. It mounts up super easy. Way more ergonomic. Other ones, like I mentioned, they go in straight. This one's just easier to use. And I think personally, one of the biggest reasons to get your own personal charger is the fact that it's a little bit cheaper overall. When you charge one in public, you're just paying a little bit more for it. Well, not only is it cheaper, it could save you money overall, but you're also not going to get stuck without a charger at some point, especially if you get the portable model. It's something you can just put inside your vehicle and take with you. But if you have one at your home, you never have to worry about showing up to a charging station and finding an empty spot, which is going to be more of a problem in the future.
Let me know what you think in the comments down below.
So if you're in the market for an EV charger, I'd highly recommend this Andeman. Either the WS1 or the HS1, you have two different options depending on what works best for you. And make sure you check out the link in the description and the pinned comments for an extra special deal right now. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions. I'll try and answer them. Check out the next episode right up here. I'll see you there. This is a tool well done.